On this episode of Hot Rod Unlimited, we are going to look at Hot Rod Magazine and where it all began, and look at where it's all going with the all-new September 2012 issue. Hot Rod was founded in 1948 by Robert E. Peterson, who was working with the Southern California Timing Association to create the very first Hot Rod show. It was at the LA Armory here in Los Angeles. Peterson decided that he was going to make a show program, which ultimately became Hot Rod Magazine. And he sold it right there on the steps of that very first show. It was a huge success and became the voice of the industry. In 1948 and into the 50s, it really took hot rodding as a Southern California culture and spread it to the whole country. In the beginning, the magazine was really about dry lakes racing. Here in Southern California, they were running at El Mirage and places like that in their hot rods. It quickly became a magazine about drag racing in the 50s and simultaneously about guys hopping up their roadsters for street use. In the late 50s, the magazine started to cover late model domestic performance coming out of Detroit, and by then it was really involved in drag racing. As a matter of fact, the National Hot Rod Association was born right in the Hot Rod Magazine offices. As we went into the 60s, once again the magazine evolved and started covering muscle cars. And then into the 70s, the muscle cars sort of fizzled, and you saw the magazine covering vans. That was really big. Vans, Pintos, Vegas in the early 70s. A lot of people see that as the decline, but really the magazine was still selling strong. It was a big American icon even then. When the van craze finally passed, that's when the magazine first became really a retrospective title. Street machines became big. Guys were building up older Chevelles and Camaros and Roadrunners and things like that. The magazine was covering what guys were doing with 10-year-old cars instead of what they were doing with brand new cars. After the street machine phase turned into pro street, cars with the big fat tires on the back, that carried the magazine big time through the late 80s and the early 90s. Pro street was huge. As the magazine rolled into the early 2000s, a lot of people say that it lost direction a little bit, and that's really because there were so many things for Hot Rod to cover. It has never been a vertical title just covering one subject matter. It's always been about everything that goes on in the performance world. And when we redesigned the magazine in 2004, we really embraced that. And now we're looking at the September 2012 issue, and once again, it is all new. Not only have we completely redesigned the art and graphics of the magazine, we've added 40 to 50% more pages. It's just physically much thicker. But as far as direction, what we're looking to do now is to really entertain and inform. We're not just a print magazine. We've got Hot Rod TV, Hot Rod Radio, huge events, apps, video shows on the MotorTrend channel of YouTube. All this stuff, and great things are happening with them. And so I need to take all the opportunity from those brand extensions and fold them into the magazine and make the print product the best of all of those things. For example, running the new ZL1 Camaro at 200 miles an hour. We'll do a video that shows the excitement of that. Ultimately, I was in it from 190 to 200 plus miles an hour for almost 40 seconds. And in the magazine, you really get the rich experience and the detailed story about how we did that. I'm looking at this as the first interactive print magazine. We're really taking everything that we're doing online and merging it into the magazine, like taking a poll on Facebook of what readers think of a car that we're going to feature and printing that opinion right on the page. We no longer have to wait 4 months to find out what readers are thinking. And you know, there's things like that on every page, just little tidbits and factoids and quotes and information that we didn't used to include. There's more to see on every single page. Go pick up the new magazine, the September 2012 issue on your newsstand. I really hope you'll enjoy it. But let us know. Interact with us. Comment right here on YouTube, go look at our Facebook page, or email us at hotrod@hotrod.com.